This material is intended for general informational purposes only and does not constitute legal advice. The law varies by jurisdiction and is constantly changing. For legal advice, you should consult a lawyer that can apply the appropriate law to the facts in your case. Aloha, I'm Coralie Chun Matayoshi, and welcome to my legal podcast, What's the Law? Each week, you will learn valuable information about various legal topics to help you navigate life's ups and downs, and even when things go sideways. So with me today is John Yamani. He's a partner in the law firm of Levitt Yamani and Soldner. John came from humble beginnings. He grew up on a pineapple plantation on Lana'i. And for the past, since 1981, he's devoted his entire legal career to helping victims of personal injury, including about 25 criminal and civil trials. John is considered one of Hawaii's super lawyers, and we've known each other for a long time because our kids went to babysitter together. Remember Auntie Margie?
Yeah, up in Palolo Valley.
Yeah, that was a long time ago.
Yes, it was.
Almost 1 million registered vehicles in the state of Hawaii. We have about 10,000 serious accidents a year, and unfortunately about 120 to 150 are fatalities. What are the first things that you should do after an accident has occurred?
The most important thing is call the police.
Okay.
You need to get the police involved so they can do their investigation and document what happened.
Mm-hmm.
The other thing you need to do is take your own pictures.
Okay.
In this day and age, everybody has a cell phone.
Right.
And so you can take pictures to document what happened.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we've had cases where in hit and runs,
mm-hmm.
people whip out their cell phone.
Mm.
They're able to take a picture
wow.
of the license plate of the offending driver.
Wow.
And so when the cops show up, they're on their way to find out where the driver is and what happened to
them.
That's
a really good idea.
Yeah.
What about witnesses or taking, I guess that's police would do that.
You would be surprised.
Uh-huh.
I mean, a lot of times in our car crashes, there are witnesses.
Mm-hmm.
And our clients will tell us, oh yeah, but you know, there was a witness there.
But where
he
are
told
they?
Me that. But it's nowhere in the police report. So it's always a good idea for
mm-hmm.
you to do your own investigation
mm-hmm.
and get your own information if you can.
Okay. Yeah. What about going to a doctor?
Okay. What happens is when people get hurt in car crashes,
mm-hmm.
a lot of times they're afraid to get into the ambulance, to go
mm-hmm.
to the emergency room, to have their injuries checked out, because they don't know who's going to pay for their medical bills.
Oh, that's true.
But in Hawaii, because we have no-fault insurance,
uh-huh.
your no-fault insurance will pay.
Will cover you.
Exactly.
Oh, okay.
It will cover you. So if you have to go by ambulance,
mm-hmm.
the no-fault insurance will pay for your
mm-hmm.
ambulance bill.
Mm.
If they take you to the emergency room, your no-fault insurance will pay for your emergency
mm.
room bill.
Okay.
They'll pay for whatever tests the doctors need to do.
Mm-hmm.
They'll pay for the doctor visits.
And even if it's your fault, because it's no fault.
Exactly.
That's great.
If you have no fault insurance, it's there to provide you the medical coverage so that you can get whatever injuries you got
mm-hmm.
taken care of.
Right.
They will also pay for any type of follow-up visits
mm-hmm.
and rehabilitation, like physical therapy,
mm-hmm.
massage. They even pay for chiropractor visits.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
And now they even pay for acupuncture.
So what if the accident, or what are the most frequent causes of accidents? Speeding is a leading cause of death in Hawaii. And why is speeding so dangerous?
What happens is when you're speeding, it cuts your reaction time.
Mm.
So you don't have enough time to react to what's going on in front of you.
Mm-hmm.
Most of our car crashes are caused by somebody rear-ending somebody.
It's going too fast.
Following too close, not paying attention,
mm-hmm.
being distracted. And if you're speeding and the car in front of you suddenly stops, you don't have enough time and room
mm-hmm.
to stop in time.
Or you might swerve or something like that and then cause another accident.
Exactly.
Right?
Exactly.
So what about distracted driving? It's one of the major causes of accidents in the U.S. and it's a big problem in Hawaii, especially among young people who think nothing of texting or posting something on social media while they're driving. Have you seen an increase in that?
Oh yeah, and a lot of times because they're distracted and not paying attention, the car crash is worse.
Oh.
Yeah, because they don't they're
it
not
just
looking
goes right in there,
and
yeah.
they rear end the person yeah. in front of them because mm-hmm. they were too busy on their cell phone.
Mm-hmm.
We've had cases where we actually end up having to go through litigation so that we can find out their cell phone number
oh.
and subpoena their records.
Oh. So if they say, I wasn't on there, well, yes, you were on that date and that time.
Exactly.
Huh.
And we can also get witness information, people that saw them on the cell phone just mm-hmm. before it happened.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that's how we are able to prove those kinds of cases.
Mm-hmm.
The other concern we have, of course, with distracted driving is DUI.
Oh, okay.
People drinking and driving.
Uh-huh.
I mean, that is such a problem here in Hawaii.
Mm-hmm.
It's helped that the legislature has passed a law making it a lower blood alcohol level
right.
for a person to be found responsible
mm-hmm.
for DUI. Because it used to be 0.1,
mm-hmm.
now it's a 0.08.
Mm-hmm.
And so that has made it easier for us to prove cases against drunk drivers.
Mm-hmm. What about other kinds of distracted driver, like people eating or they're talking to other people? Is that hard to prove? I guess
that one's a little tougher to prove.
Did you see him eating?
Yeah, that's a little harder unless the McDonald's is all over their lap after the crash and talking and listening to the radio, putting on makeup. You know, unless we have witnesses
mm-hmm.
that can prove that kind of stuff, it's a little bit more difficult.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, we feel that it's very important that if a person observes any kind of distracted driving, that they report it to the police
mm-hmm.
when they're investigating the car crash.
Mm-hmm.
We've had clients who have interacted with the offending driver
mm-hmm.
and mm-hmm. in their interaction realize, hey, that guy smells like he's been drinking.
Right.
And so then they tell the police officer,
mm-hmm.
so the police officer can do a more detailed investigation,
mm-hmm.
maybe do the field sobriety test,
mm-hmm.
and if they have enough evidence, take them down to the station and make
mm-hmm.
them do a blood or a breath test
mm-hmm.
to prove the DUI.
Oh, that's a good idea. What about drowsy driving? A lot of people fall asleep on the wheel, they're tired, and what about that?
You know, that is also a problem, especially in Hawaii,
yeah.
when people have to work more than
mm-hmm.
one job just
right.
to get by.
Mm-hmm.
We've actually had situations where we've gone after the employer
mm.
because mm. they require the driver to work long hours, to work overtime,
mm-hmm.
and work more hours than it is safe.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, we in certain situations, we're actually able to prove that the employer was responsible
wow.
for the person being too tired to
uh-huh.
drive.
Wow, wow, that's an interesting concept. How do you prove these things? How would you use the police records or doctor records to try to show that these things happened?
Usually we have to subpoena the evidence.
Okay.
So if the case goes into litigation, we have to file a lawsuit.
Mm-hmm.
We go through what is called a discovery phase. And in the discovery phase, we have subpoena powers. So we can, for example, subpoena doctor records. We can, of course, subpoena the DUI police report.
Mm.
We can subpoena cell phone records to see if they're on the cell phone. And we can subpoena employer records to see what kind of work hours that person was involved in.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And could you also find out if somebody had a previous DUI and maybe that kind of a habitual?
Exactly. One of the first things we always do whenever we get a new case is we check out the offending driver's traffic abstract.
That must be interesting.
It's public record.
That's true.
It's all on the internet.
Uh-huh.
And we can just go to the internet and pull up those records and find out.
Wow. Okay.
That's how we also find out if maybe the person doesn't have a driver's license. Sometimes the police don't catch that because, you know, they don't run the check. But we can run the person's traffic abstract and see
mm-hmm.
if their license was suspended because of a prior DUI.
Wow. Can you think of a remarkable situation that you might have had in the past that you, like an egregious somebody was drunk or they're speeding and what kind of injuries somebody sustained? Have you had, I'm sure you've had some pretty bad cases where people have had a lot of lost wages or permanent injuries. Can you tell me about any of that kind of cases?
Well, you know, one case comes to mind is an adult child was driving daddy's car.
Okay.
And he got drunk and he caused a car crash. In that case, we investigated to find out where he was drinking to see if there is what we call a dram shop.
And that's liability of the liquor dispenser, like the hotel.
In a dram shop act, we can go after the restaurant or the bar he was drinking at. We've had cases where we actually go after the store where the drunk driver went and bought liquor. He was already drunk when he bought the liquor, bought more liquor, got more drunk, and then caused the car crash that injured our client. We've had situations where because of our investigation and the poor driving record, we were able to prove that the parent or the owner of the car had no business loaning the car and trying to find additional coverage so we can get compensation
for the parents of the kid that caused the accident. Well, that's
interesting. That's why it's so important, especially for parents, parents of minor children, to have lots of insurance coverage, because if your child's under the age of 18, you're responsible for their actions.
Right, and obviously the kid doesn't have any money, so they're gonna go after you, right?
Exactly, exactly.
Wow. That's it, so interesting. Well, that's a wrap. I wanna thank John Yamane for his time and expertise, and thank you for joining us on What's the Law. Until next time, ahui ho.